Namaskara. I'm Dr. Sunita Rana Agarwal and I'm from Dr. Agarwal Hospital's Bangalore. I'm an eye surgeon and I'm also medical genomics. Some of the most common causes of red eye is infection, allergy, foreign body, glaucoma. These are the most important. However, there can be so many others like blepharitis and so many other reasons as well. Here we're going to only be talking about first thing that we need to make sure about is acute catarrhal conjunctivitis, or we call it ACCO, or conjunctivitis or red eye. Some places we also call it Madras eye, or wherever it became more popular, we started calling it with that. That many times red eye that came during spring or in the rainy season, we actually exhausted all the antibiotics of our city. This has not happened just once or twice. That's why I'm trying to tell you about red eyes, so we can prevent it rather than try to treat it. This is called conjunctivitis, and here infection is the cause. One of the most important ways to prevent any of these infection, foreign body, allergy, is when you come from outside, wash your hands, wash your face, wash your eyes. Keep your eyes open and wash your eyes so that all that elements that can produce all these things have been washed out. Second, if your eye is sticking together in the morning, that means it is an infection and most likely bacterial. You will need to visit an eye doctor. You will need to start an antibiotic, eye drop and ointment. However, when it is allergy, then we don't need the antibiotic. We need steroids. So there's a big difference here. If it's infection, no steroid. If there is no infection, if it's an allergy, definitely steroid or non-steroidal anti-inflammatory. But the tip of the pyramid is still dryness of the eye. Why do these things come? Because our eyes are too dry, involution, whatever name you want to give it. This dryness we can treat to some extent by taking OTC drugs from the counter called artificial tears and using a night cream at night. So we put little cream on our fingertips and massage the lash margins. This way we're able to take care of allergies and infections. If we learn to wash our face and eyes, we've also taken care of foreign body. For the rest of it, you will need an eye doctor. When all these situations like glaucoma comes in, then we need to go to gene therapy, because here we can treat the glaucoma with gene therapy. Take one drop of blood, own DNA and fetal stem cells, as injections, we are able to remove glaucoma.